do talk to me at the end of Cedric. As I said, Pastor Sheila is going to tell us what's going to happen in 2017 and why is it so important. 2016 is so important to us. She's going to show us a prophecy for 2017.
That was given to a gentleman called Smith Wigglesworth. Some of you may have heard him. So I'm going to read his prophecy and then just explain a couple of things about it. So this is what was given to Smith Wigglesworth in 1947. During the next few decades, there will be two distinct moves of the Holy Spirit across the Church in Great Britain.
On Great Britain,
the first move will affect every church that is open to receive it and will be characterized by a return of the baptism and gifts of the Holy Spirit.
और पहली मूवमेंट उस चर्च से होगी जो इसे पाले का पवित्र आत्मा को और इसकी सारे तत्वों को समझेगा।
The second move of the Holy Spirit will result in people leaving historic churches and planting new churches.
और दूसरी मूवमेंट उसमें होगी कि लोग हिस्टोरिकल पुरानी चर्चों को छोड़कर नई चीजें करेंगे।
In each of these moves, the people will say, "This is the great revival." But the Lord says no, neither of these are the great revival, but steps towards it.
और इन सब चीजों को लोग देखकर लोग कहेंगे कि शायद यही रिवाइवल है, लेकिन ये रिवाइवल नहीं होगा, ये सिर्फ एक स्तर होगा रिवाइवल की तरफ.
When the church, the new church movement wanes, declines, there will be a coming together of the Word and the Spirit.
और इस चर्च में जो है वो मूवमेंट होगी बहुत सारी पवित्र आत्मा की और बहुत सारी नेशंस इसमें जुड़ेंगी।
When the Word and the Spirit come together, there will be the biggest movement of the Holy Spirit that this nation and indeed the world has ever seen.
और जब पवित्र आत्मा और वचन साथ में जुड़ जाएंगे तो तब बहुत बड़ी बड़ी बातें होंगी जो सारी दुनिया देखेगी।
It will mark the beginning of a revival which will eclipse anything that has been witnessed in Great Britain.
और ये गवाही होगी बहुत सारी चीजों की जो कि इस ग्रेट ब्रिटेन में देखी जाएंगी.
The outpouring of God's Spirit will flow over from the UK to Europe.
और पवित्र आत्मा की जो आउटपोरिंग है वो यूके से शुरू होगी यूरोप तक जाएगी.
And there will begin a missionary move to the ends of the earth.
और यहाँ से बहुत सारे मिशनरी काम शुरू होंगे जो दुनिया के अंत तक जाएंगे.
So that was given to this nation in 1947.
और ये prophecy इस nation को 1947 में दी गई थी.
During the month of March of this year,
मार्च के महीने में,
the number of Christians had a particular verse in the book of Daniel.
और बहुत सारे मसीहों को दानियल की किताब में से ये आयत मिली है.
And it was when Daniel read the book of Jeremiah and realized that the 70 years bondage that Israel had been in had come to an end.
और उसमें यरमाया की ही एक आयत जो कि दानियल में भी बताई गई है जिसमें लिखा है कि 70 साल की उनकी जो गुलामी थी जो वो खत्म हो गई इसराइल की.
And we heard the Spirit say that this nation had been in spiritual bondage for 70 years.
और उसमें बताया गया है कि ये जो कौम है वो 70 साल तक एक स्पिरिचुअल बॉन्डेज में गुलामी में आखिर में रही है.
But if you add 70 years onto 1947, you get 2017.
और अगर आप इन सब कैलकुलेशन को इकट्ठा करेंगे 1947 going hai.
You have started ministries.
Aapne ministries start ki hai.
But many of you have been very faithful in your ministries.
Aur aap bahut sare vafadar rahe hain khuda ke saath.
And these are the vessels.
Aur yehi wo bartan hai.
That God will use.
Jo khuda aap istemal karega.
Because when He pours out His Spirit over a nation,
aur jab wo apni aatma de deta hai ek nation ke upar,
He has to have vessels to bless.
Toh wo unhe usse vessels chahiye jinko wo bartan banakar istemal kar sake.
So I stand before you tonight.
Aur aaj main aapke samne khadi hu.
And I believe.
Aur main vishwas karti hu.
That this is God's time.
Ki yehi khuda ka samay hai.
And you.
Aur aap.
God's people.
Aap sabhi ke liye.
So that is the general context. If you want to know more about that, we have these booklets available about you as ministries and churches can actually prepare for the time when one Sunday you will come to your church and there will be hundreds of people queuing up who have had an experience of Jesus Christ but have no context.
और ये मैंने आपको थोड़ा बताया है अभी, लेकिन ये एक बुकलेट है जो तैयार की गई है कि 2017 में हम क्या विश्वास करते हैं कि इस जमीन पर होने वाला है, और एक हो सकता है कि एक संडे आप चर्च जाएं और सारे चर्च भरे हो और आप ये सोचे कि क्या हो रहा है, लेकिन हम विश्वास करते हैं कि रिवाइवल जो कि 2017 में होने वाला है आप इस किताब से और ज्यादा पढ़ सकते हैं.
So the question is, are we ready?
तो सवाल ये है कि क्या हम तैयार हैं?
Yes. The Spirit of the Lord is coming to you today. And I hope that you've come here tonight to bless to you and Cedric. But there is a blessing here for you.
और हो सकता है कि आज हमें आप बरकत देने आए हैं मुझे और सभी को, लेकिन आप सबकी भी बरकत इसी में छिपी है.
We are in a Methodist church tonight.
और हम एक मेथोडिस्ट चर्च में हैं आज.
They were the churches that led revival in the 19th century.
और 19th century में इन्हीं चर्चेस से रिवाइवल शुरू हुआ था.
And God used the Methodist church.
और खुदा ने मेथोडिस्ट चर्च को यूज किया.
To restore the amazing truth that in Christ we can be holy.
और
in Christ we can live a holy life.
ये उनको बताया, उनके जरिए से हमें बताया कि यीशु मसीह के द्वारा हम पवित्र बन सकते हैं.
So there is a well of blessing that we are standing on tonight.
और ये बहुत बरकत की बात है कि हम मेथोडिस्ट चर्च में ही आज खड़े हैं.
For those people that were used by God 200 years ago.
और जो लोग 2000 साल पहले 200 साल वापस नहीं जाना चाहते.
Are not here now.
और आज यहाँ पर है.
It's you that are here.
और आज है आप यहाँ पे.
It's you He gives the torch to now.
और आप ही को वो रोशनी दिखा रहा है आज.
Because Christ has said.
और परमेश्वर यीशु मसीह ने कहा है,
When I am lifted up,
जब मुझे ऊपर उठाया गया है,
I will draw all people to myself.
तो मैं आप सभी को ऊपर उठाऊंगा अपने साथ.
So as we meet here in the presence of the Lord,
और आज हम उसकी हजूरी में यहाँ पर इकट्ठे हुए हैं.
There is blessing for you.
और आपके लिए ये बरकत है.
There is blessing for our neighbors.
और हमारे पड़ोसियों के लिए एक बरकत है.
For those who go the way of the gurus.
और जो यहाँ पर साथ में हैं उनके लिए भी बरकत है.
Those who come out of Hinduism.
और जो हिंदुइज्म से बाहर निकले हैं उनके लिए भी एक बरकत है.
Those who are followers of the Prophet Muhammad.
और जो कि मोहम्मद को फॉलो करते हैं उनके लिए भी बरकत है.
The light of Christ will shine.
और यीशु मसीह की रोशनी चमकेगी.
Amen.
I just want you to, in your hearts, just reach out to them I also expect the Lord to bless you as well. Because as I said in the opening, I believe that this has been decreed by God from heaven, but it still has to be outworked on earth. And so I'm going to pray, and I'm going to mount and anoint their feet with oil and your hands. Alright. I just want to say that I count as a personal privilege. Count you as friends. Because I recognize your ministry. The one that you've had, and the one that you will have. So I said, we can sing that. So we ask the Lord of heaven and earth to anoint you now. And it's the one that called you into his kingdom. And it's the one to whom we are accountable. And I pray now that through his blessing and his guidance, you will serve him through the Acts ministry. In those times when people acknowledge your ministry, in the times when they don't, in the times of blessing, and in times of trial. Just pray that as you open your hearts to others, they will receive the open heart of the Lord. Pray that as you reach out, you will also always focus on the Lord and reach up. Because it is he that commissions, it is he that sends you forth. So now I'm going to anoint you royal in accordance with scripture. And as I do that, I believe the Holy Spirit will give you increased power. He will bless your family, he will bless your marriage, and he will give to you the desires of your heart.
She's going to come and share that gift with us now. Just be blessed in Jesus' name.